Today on the Ammunition Guides podcast, Dave and I are going to talk about our favorite bullets for self-defense, what you should be loading in your EDC handguns.
Hello, friends and lovers. This is Dave Trillo, and you're listening to the Ammunition Podcast brought to you by none other than ammo.com. Chris, there's a lot of self-defense ammo on the market, and you cannot see that I'm doing the air quotes around self-defense ammo because a lot of it's junk loaded with JHPs, but which you just can't really trust to deliver the terminal expansion and penetration that are both requisite to effectively neutralize a threat, as we like to euphemistically put it in the ammo sales world.
Dave, you're absolutely right. There are a lot of hollow points out there that maybe don't get the job done. And if you want to get the job done, make sure you click that like and subscribe button down below. Click on the link in the pinned comment or the description. Get your free coupon at ammo.com. But I want to prerequisite this a little bit. We're not going to talk about caliber-specific hollow points today. We're just going to talk about hollow points in general and what the high-performing hollow points are that you should probably be looking at to load into your concealed carry handgun or your EDC or even just your home defense handgun, regardless of what caliber it is, because these rounds will get the job done. And we're going to start off with a classic, and that's the Hornady Critical Defense. Now, this one's a little bit different than your traditional hollow point because it has a polymer tip. Dave, what's the deal with that tip on there?
The idea behind a polymer tip is that it prevents the nose cavity of the bullet from getting clogged up with fabric and other debris that could impair terminal expansion after penetration. We really want the bullet to expand after it strikes soft tissue. It does more damage. It spreads more energy outwards. It minimizes the chances of potentially disastrous over-penetration. Yeah. And the Hornady Critical Defense is loaded with what's essentially Hornady's XTP with just a little polymer column inside.
And I like it that Hornady basically said, okay, instead of having the fabric clog the hollow point, we're just going to do it, but we're using this polymer column to basically initiate expansion once it impacts soft tissue, which I think is a really cool and innovative idea. Moving on to our next favorite hollow point, and again, these are not in any specific order, is going to be the Spear Gold Dot. Now, I will admit shamelessly, this is one of my personal favorites. To put it in a way that is somewhat cliche, honestly, they are the gold standard by which many self-defense hollow points are measured by, because Spear was some of the first ones to come out after the whole 1986 Miami shootout.
It's the first true bonded pistol bullet to hit the market. And when I say bonded, I mean Spear starts out with an alloyed lead core. They soak it in an electrochemical bath to kind of fuse it one atom at a time to its copper alloy jacket. And that creates a perfectly concentric jacket, which is good because that enhances gyroscopic stability for better accuracy. More importantly, it really toughens the bullet up.
Spear made this bonded hollow point to make sure that jacket doesn't shear off basically once the hollow point opens up. And it stays together as one piece, imparts more kinetic energy onto the target, and can really do a lot of damage. Spear Gold Dot's definitely a great choice if you are going to conceal carry. The next big one on our list came from another hollow point, the Federal HST. Now, of course, this was predated by the Federal Hydra Shock, which is another favorite of mine, especially 9mm. But man, these HSTs are pretty nasty, and these are also very popular in the law enforcement community, if I'm not mistaken.
Extremely. Now, interestingly enough, the HST does not have a bonded jacket, but Federal has engineered it in such a way that it really doesn't matter. It still just destroys barriers and retains the virtually entirety of its weight before it comes to a rest within soft tissue.
It's pretty nasty. If you've looked at some of the ballistic testing on these HSTs, it's really disgusting what these hollow points can do. Now, let's talk about one that's a little bit more on the expensive side, but man, if you want terminal performance, this is probably what you need to be looking for, and that is none other than the Winchester PDX-1. That, of course, was predated by the Ranger T, which was formerly known as the Black Talon. These hollow points will really expand, and I think that's one of their things that really sets them apart. You can find PDX-1 fairly easily if you can find Winchester self-defense ammo, and yeah, you should not feel undergunned or feel like you're carrying something inferior when you're carrying a Winchester hollow point.
We weren't sure whether to include the next one in our list, but I think it has a lot of promise. I wouldn't feel unconfident carrying this one.
Yeah, and that is none other than the Remington Golden Saber. These really shot onto the scene after the Miami incident, along with the Speer Gold Dot, and was the carry ammo for a lot of law enforcement for some time. But I'll say it really did not pick up as much steam as you would think it was compared to the Gold Dot. And then, of course, when Federal and Hornady and Winchester got involved, has really kind of fallen out of favor in the market. And I'll be honest with you, these are a little pricey, even more expensive than Winchester PDX-1 at times, and really kind of lives on an older design.
What the Golden Saber bullet does is it has a harder than normal brass jacket. They call it a brass jacket at hollow point. If you look at the Golden Saber, you'll notice that it has kind of an aggressive spiral cut around its nose cavity. And when the bullet enters a soft medium, it's rugged enough to punch through until those spiral cuts kind of yield to give way to expansion.
The old style Golden Sabers will do the job, definitely, if you can put them where you need to have them.
Yeah. So I think we've just covered our top picks for conventional jacketed hollow point ammo.
The hollow point design hasn't changed a lot. There have been some advancements, like we're talking about the bonded jacket and things like that, the polymer tips of the critical defense. But there are some companies who have went above and beyond, who have tried to really change the game. And some of these worked and some of them really didn't. But we wanted to bring them up in our list here because I think it's kind of interesting to look at some of these. And my personal favorite, when this came out, I looked at this and I'm like, this is ridiculous. It is the G2 Research RIP bullet. Now, this is the nastiest looking bullet on our list. It has the most menacing look to it. And the price tag was pretty menacing as well. But the concept behind this is a monolithic bullet. It was basically CNC machined, each one individually. And it had basically these little spikes that basically once they hit, you know, soft target, would break off, expand, fragment. And you'd have this little copper core that would do all the penetration. And I think that's really where the RIP round lost out, was it didn't have deep enough penetration.
The RIP, its terminal ballistics are dramatic, fascinating to look at a model of. You just see these little copper shards go in every direction. But the remaining actual core of the bullet, like you say, it's lost a significant percentage of its weight, and it just can't penetrate that deeply.
If you've seen some of the testing that they've done with these bullets, they look horrible. But the thing is, there is no penetration. And I think that's one thing that a lot of people don't understand, is that these bullets need to penetrate. They need to penetrate deep to stop a threat, to make them stop. And I just feel like the RIP round is really just kind of for show, for lack of a better term.
To that end, though, there are self-defense bullets that don't expand at all, and which retain 100% of their weight.
Yeah, these were some that you were more familiar with than I was, honestly, because I guess I'm more of a traditionalist. But the first one we're going to touch base on is the Black Hills Honey Badger. Now, Dave, walk us through this one.
The Honey Badger, no other way to describe it, it looks like a Phillips head drill bit.
Yep.
And the idea is, when that thing plunges into soft tissue, it doesn't expand at all. Instead, its tiny lateral grooves channel soft tissues. They scoop them up and jet them outward even faster than the bullet itself is traveling. So it's just blasting the threat's own soft tissues outward at incredibly high rates. This creates an enormous wound cavity. Meanwhile, the bullet itself, it's solid copper, which is a much tougher, more ductile metal than lead. It's retaining 100% of its weight as it proceeds to just penetrate inward. The neat thing about the Black Hills Honey Badger is that it doesn't need to expand, so it doesn't really pose that threat of over-penetration caused by when a JHP fails to expand altogether. It's going to produce its desired terminal effect. I do believe if it holds up to every promise that it offers, it deserves to become the standard for self-defense. The Honey Badger is not the only bullet that completely did away with the hollow point. We want to kind of touch on another that I'm a little less certain of its efficacy, and that's the Inceptor ARX.
These things you were telling me are made out of polymer and are incredibly lightweight. So I think we're kind of going for really the concept of speed kills on this bullet, but these are quite a different style of projectile compared to something like a Speer Gold Dot.
It really looks futuristic. And the ARX works, it's shaped differently, but it works on a similar principle to the Honey Badger. Those grooves kind of scoop up soft tissue and jet them out even faster than the bullet itself is traveling to create a large semi-permanent wound cavity. To that end, I'm just not confident enough recommending this one until we've seen a little more testing and and testing has been slow because people are apprehensive about so alien-looking a projectile. We got a couple special situation types of self-defense bullets. Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. One of them depends on whether you carry a snub-nosed revolver, and the other one depends on whether you're worried about Smokey and Yogi jacking you up.
Absolutely. So let's talk about those snub-nosed and talk about a bullet type that we haven't touched on the channel too much, and that is using wad-cutter bullets for self-defense. Now, this has been a mainstream idea for a long time, especially back in the older days when police officers and federal agents were carrying revolvers more consistently. And the actual FBI load when they were carrying their revolvers, if I'm not mistaken, was a 38 Special Plus P with a wad cutter in it. And these bullets were, in the past have been considered like just competition bullets because they make nice little round holes on your paper mm-hmm. targets. But these can do a lot of damage when loaded properly.
A wad cutter is kind of it's like the loophole. It's like, here's a bullet that does damage without needing to expand. So it's perfect for revolvers that couldn't give a bullet enough energy for expansion anyway.
Wad cutter, a great alternate choice if you're carrying a snub-nosed revolver or something really tiny. Definitely something to consider. Now, you touched on bear defense, one of my personal favorite topics. And honestly, the thing that gets the most work done is what is referred to as a hard cast lead bullet. Hard cast lead allows you to punch through all of that hard bone, sinew, tissue, muscle mass, and get to the vital organs of the bear. It's not a nice thing to think about, but that's really what you have to do. You have to get to those vital organs because I've heard stories of hunters like center mass on a bear right to the heart and the thing keeps going. So you've got to do as much damage as you can if you're going to survive that encounter. Dave, let's go ahead and wrap this up here. We've talked about our favorite hollow points, and everybody's going to ask us, which one should I buy? Which one's going to work best? And I think, honestly, the answer is most all of these ones on our list, especially the first five that we touched on, all going to be amazing choices, and all of which you can get here at ammo.com. Make sure you click that link down in the description. But what's going to be your go-to for people who say, Dave, which one should I buy?
What people ask me that often, and it's always a toss-up. I like Federal HST and Gold Dot pretty much equally. Any minute differences in their performance is really negligible. You'll be pleased with either. If I had to give it to one, though, I still think the Gold Dot reigns supreme.
Dave, that's got to be my answer as well. I love my Spear Gold Dots. I honestly love the nickel-plated cases. They're so slick when they feed into the chamber. I really enjoy them. And they're not ridiculously expensive like some other specialized hollow points that don't necessarily give you any better terminal performance. But yeah, Federal HST and even my Winchester PDX-1 is going to be a close second if I had to make a recommendation. But that's not to say that any of these are better than the others. They're all going to get the job done if you do your part. And to do that, you need to make sure that you're practicing. So make sure you get all of your practice ammo here at ammo.com, and we'll see you out on the range.